Regen with a high float hydraulic block.
When we're engaging and lowering our openers, there's this CBEA counterbalance valve. What that does is, instead of all of the oil going back to the tractor, it sends some of the oil back to the cylinder. We'll explain that more in detail when we get into the valve. Our high float block has a feature called regen. All that is, instead of sending all of the oil back to the tractor, we can allow some of the oil to just shortcut from one side of the circuit to the other to speed up the lower time. To do so, we use a check valve, a COFA check valve. It's a pilot operated check valve. And a counterbalance valve. So once the pressures have come to the state where the pilot opens for the check valve, it allows flow to go from the rod end to the base end without having to return all the way to the tractor. This is a factory adjustment for this pressure on this counterbalance valve. No need to tamper with this system at all. If your openers are dropping on a bore grow drill overnight, it's an indicator that you have a leaking cylinder internally. So what would happen is your oil is moving from rod to base end and allowing the openers to go down. There is procedures on the website how to check and find that, but another scenario could arise. The openers are going down in a burp as you're going down the road. So what could be happening is the original drills had a check valve like this. It was labeled CKGV and it went in this location. And what would happen is, as the pressure changed from rod end to base end of the cylinders, you get a bit of an imbalance there and it could potentially open the check valve within this valve. Then the openers would go down with a burst. Now we've added this CAGL, where it takes quite a bit more pressure differential for anything like that to happen. So it safely stays up a lot longer. We release the bulletin back in 2017, number 15 of 2017, outlining how to identify the two different problems and what to check for. So let's review what we've learned about regen. For this, we're going to look at the 3441-53 hydraulic block. So when we look down at the bottom, we look where our pressure oil comes in on the TRTRDC-P from the tractor. It'll enter the directional control spool on the P port and exit on the A port for downforce, right? So lower our openers and away we go. Now we have the ability to speed up that lowering process with a function called regen. So regen is the CBEA counterbalance valve and the COFA pilot operated check valve working in conjunction with each other to lower the openers. So when we lower our openers, we're sending quite a bit of oil back to the tractor from the rod end and replenishing it on the base end to lower the openers. So what regen can do is shortcut that process, and how that works is as such. So the CBAA counterbalance valve holds pressure on the top side of this circuit. The COFA pilot operated check valve has this ball that's pushed over to close this path between rod end and base end. This pilot pressure comes from the return side of things. So if there is very little return back pressure on this side of the circuit, it would allow this pilot operated check to open up and send pressure oil back. We have to have the counterbalance valve to add some back pressure to the circuit, because of course if this is allowed to just free float back, it would avoid going to the down and just return to sump. So this counterbalance valve simply holds pressure to allow some of the oil to go back over to the base end until the base end pushes the cylinders down and the openers are contacting the ground. Then the pressure will climb on the base end and it'll close this PO check. The other thing we're looking at on this picture is the CAGL counterbalance valve that is designed to stop a rapid opener drop situation in transport. So what is actually happening is the pressure is leaking from the rod end side of things. So the DRL-R is rod end or return when the openers are going down. When they're sitting stationary, so the wings are up and all of our mainframe hydraulic cylinders for our openers have quite a bit of pressure on the rod end side of things. If any of those cylinders are leaking oil from rod end to base end, what they're in effect doing is the pressure is starting to climb on the base end and it's actually reducing a little bit on the rod end. So as that pressure climbs on the base end, that pressure oil is going to go over, and we see these pilots for the counterbalance valves. So as that pilot pressure climbs, you can see it'll shift this over and down it'll go. What the counterbalance does, as opposed to a standard check valve, is it makes this quite a bit harder for this to happen, because this is held at approximately 2000 PSI. Where if it was just the old standard PO check valve, it would open up quite easily. And again, because our pressure on the number three wasn't the same, we'd allow all that flood of oil to go over here and replenish the base end of the cylinders, and the openers would drop with a bit of a burst.